Now we'll do the standing arm series. Bring your heels together. Feet are just a little bit apart. The heels are touching, but the balls of the feet are not too far apart. Don't exaggerate this position. Bring your arms directly in front of you. Weight is on the balls of the feet, and you're going to bend your elbows up towards the ceiling, but keep a 90-degree angle and bring them back down. Here we go. And one, and one, and two. You're resisting both ways. Resist up, resist down. And four, again, and five, and out. And don't drop the elbows, keep the support, and eight, and stop. Now bring your arms to the side position and bend them up on one and one. It's almost like they're bending like a goalpost, straight up to the ceiling and straight back out. Keep the arms in front of you. They're slightly in front of your vision. And seven, and eight, and stop. Bring the arms forward and elbows glued to the sides. Curls, one, and down, and two, and down, and three, and down, and four. Keep it moving, breathe. Keep the weight forward on the balls of the feet, and up, and down, and up, and stop. Separate the heels slightly, go to parallel position and drop your body all the way down for boxing. Pull your elbows up in towards your waist and flatten out your back like a tabletop. And stretch the right arm out and both arms in. Left arm up and right arm back and in. Right arm up, left arm back, both arms in. Inhale, stretch. Exhale, bend. Two more. Breathe in. Breathe out. Last time, stretch the arms, but don't move the hips. Now round down. Drop it down. Roll up through the spine and go back to your Pilates V. Your heels are together, and you're going to lift for mermaid. Right arm up, stretch over to the side, lengthening, and come up tall. This is like the mermaid, but it's standing. It's called sides. Lengthen your sides, and come up tall, and switch. And up and over, lengthening, and come up tall, and switch. Up and over, lengthening, keep it reaching, and come up tall. Bend the knees, go back to parallel position, and round your spine over. Then lift up to tabletop back again and do the bug, which is the hug bent over. And arms open, and arms closed. And arms open, and remember we're moving from the shoulders, not from the elbows. So keep the whole arm moving. And now exhale opening, and inhale closing. Think of the whole shape moving like crab's arms. They're opening, and stop. Round it down. Roll up through the spine. Bring your heels together again for the zip. Your knuckles are together and you're going to zip everything up and zip it down. Remember, the zipper's going to stop at your breastbone. Don't zip the zipper all the way up to your neck. It stops at the breastbone and zip back down. Don't let your heels come apart. Rise up and hold and lift the elbows higher than the wrists if you can. Good. Without lifting the shoulders up. And come down. Next is chest expansion. Bring your arms in front of you, pinch the shoulders down and back, rise up on your tippy toes, but don't let the heels come apart. And then slowly lower the heels as you bring the arms forward. Now add the head. Rise up and hold, look to the right, look to the left, look to the center, and exhale. Again, breathe in, hold your breath, look to the left, look to the right. Look to the center and exhale. Two more. Rise up. Hold your breath. Look to the right. Keep your breath held. Keep your breath held. And exhale. And last time, inhale. Push the arms behind you. Turn the head left. Turn it right. Center the head. And exhale. And the last one is little arm circles. Outside circles as the arms go up. And inside circles as the arms. Now you rise. Rise up. Rise up. Rise up, rise up, rise up, and lower the heels gracefully as the arms come down. Slowly raise the heels. Don't push the heels apart. The heels stay together. The circles are inside. Outside circles away from the center of the body, and inside circles towards the center of the body. Let the arms totally relax. Thank you very much.